know, just a little update for you guys. I guess I know you guys ask for a lot of my team videos, which is kind of cool. I appreciate that a lot. Nothing really going on much in the my team world. They have these new throwback moments players that look really nice. They have a Steve Nash, Gordon Hayward, and Robert Parrish Galaxy Opal. I bet that Hayward's probably going for a lot. That card's always, you know, he already has a good jump shot. And then I'm sure no one's really buying the Nash because Nash is kind of too small to play nowadays. Series packs. Let's check those out, actually. Actually, let's check out the team first. The reason why you guys are here. As you can see, there's nothing really new to the My Collection part of it, but I did update the team. I put the Bay. It's a Golden State Warriors logo on there. I think it looks pretty dope, but also, thank you guys so much for the support in my last video. If you haven't checked out my video and you're into basketball or NBA or sports in general, make sure to check out my other videos I post on this channel. I posted a ESPN-inspired video with the best starting lineup on every team's history ever. So, I had the Eastern Conference I posted on last Sunday, and then this upcoming Sunday, I'm posting the Western Conference. Hopefully, you guys will enjoy that one as much as you guys enjoyed the last one. So, thank you guys so much for that. Obviously, like, subscribe, that whole jazz. We're like 100 subs away from 3K, which is crazy. So, if you want to be, you know, the next 100 people to subscribe, I'd really appreciate that. A lot. But as you can see, we still have Lonzo, Clyde, Rudy, Brian Scalabrini in the starting lineups. We have Galaxy Opal, Damian Lillard, our newly acquired Galaxy Opal, Devin Booker, which was pretty crazy in my opinion. Still need to get him that defensive shoe that I want to get him. It's like, I'm waiting for it to get really cheap. Right now it's around 10K. I'm trying to get it when it's, you know, single digit thousands. Get some like perimeter defense and stuff like that, which he really needs. Yeah, we still have Iggy. We have this LaMarcus Aldridge card, which is only in the lineup because it gives Damian Galaxy Opal, which is the only thing I care about. And we have Pink Diamond, Pink Diamond, Greg Oden. Also, I had some people comment on my last video about these cards and like, oh, don't use Kobe, don't use Andrew Booker, yada yada yada. I don't use these three cards. This is just like my best lineup that I can make right now. So this isn't like my actual like ultimate team or whatever you want to like to play. This wouldn't be a team I would actually use and play. I would have Brontis here obviously, and I wouldn't use these players at all. So don't worry about these players. Obviously Kobe's here because Kobe's the GOAT. He's one of them definitely. Okay, so we are back to where we left off in my last video. This empty spot. Now, I bet you're thinking, ASMballeR, what did you do? Did you maybe sell some players? And because all my empty's gone. Obviously, my empty's gone. I bought someone. Did I take someone's suggestion and get Luka Doncic? Did I take someone's suggestion and, you know, switch some people around and get a small forward or a power forward? Well, the answer is, there's no center here. Well, that's because I got Galaxy, Opal, Kristaps, Porzingis. Yes, Galaxy, Opal, Kristaps, Porzingis. I took a lot of people's consideration, and I haven't watched any MyTeam videos, like regular MyTeam videos in such a long time, and a lot of good players had Kristaps in their starting five, or even on the bench, so I took that into consideration. Kristaps is 7'3". He plays very smoothly. He plays like a small forward type, which I really like. He doesn't play like a big man. He has 97 mid-range, 97 three-point shot for Kristaps. Insane. 97 free throw, really good dunking stats. His post moves are insane as well. Really good ball handling skills, which is pretty important to me as a big man. You know, I want my big man to be able to, you know, pass out on pick and rolls, pick and pops, things like that. 97 block, pretty decent steal for a big man, pretty okay average perimeter defense, but a 96 interior defense for a Kristaps card is insane. 98 rebound for both offense and defense. Oh my god, very fast card. 86 speed with an 83 speed with ball, which is usually what I really try to focus on, because you know, if my big man's holding the ball, especially when I'm doing triple threat, I want to be able to, you know, boost past other guards. This one seems like it would. Really good acceleration, verticals at 90, pretty insane. He has 40 Hall of Fame. Patch, Hall of Fame patch, since Eddie Curry did. But this Eddie Curry card looks insane as well. I think I might get this card if I ever, you know, stumble upon a lot more empty. What was I going to do? Oh, yeah. So hopefully you guys liked that pickup. So, yeah, there's these prime packs that are out right now. I'm not going to get any of them because I'm not going to spend money on this 2K game. It's just not worth it. But we have George Iceman Irving from the San Antonio Spurs. Man, I bet this card is super dope looking. This beautiful signature Kawhi Leonard card, which is probably going for probably a mil plus, no doubt about it. That card probably has the best defensive stats in the game, probably. We have Gary Payton here, another great defensive player at point guard. Pascal Siakam, oh my god, the things I would do to get this card. He's like my ideal four in the NBA. Like, he's just a stretch four, he can switch off really good, he can play, honestly, almost 1-5 against some teams. Like, if I could get this Pascal Siakam card, that'd be insane. I would love to have this card. This would probably be my starting four, without a doubt. Then we have Joel Embiid, which is probably another card that's going for an insane amount. They have a prime David Robinson card, which is pretty dope. They have a Galaxy one in the card in the game, I think, already. And then we have a diamond Tony Parker, which is pretty cool. And then, yeah, like I said before, they have the Super Steve Nash card, which looks super cool, but it's probably not even going for 100k, honestly, because having a 6-foot card in the game, point guard is pretty irrelevant. We have Gordon Hayward, which is probably a really good card to have. I would love to have this card. I remember in the 2K19, you know, my team series I had the diamond Gordon Hayward on my team for such a long time because that card was so good. Robert Parrish, like I said, we have a Jeff T card, which is pretty dope, and a Luke Longley card as well. And then they still have these stupid super spotlight sim cards that are still in the game for some reason, but I've seen a lot of people play Donovan Mitchell at point guard, which seems pretty OP. I think I'd really enjoy that as well. Let's actually check out the Kawhi Leonard card. Like I said, I'm not really planning on really doing a lot in this video, so I'm kind of just wasting time right now. Wow, this card's not even going for a mil. I thought it'd go for way more than that. He has a 98 three-point shot. Oh my god. That's a crazy Kawhi card. His passing's crazy. Defense, insane. 97 speed, wow. Oh my god. He has 51 Hall of Fame badges. I can't even probably go through all the ones he has. That's so crazy. Wow. That's awesome. I wish I could get that card. The George Irving I wanted to check out as well. He's going for, wow, whoa, wait a second. Why is this card so cheap? I might have to try and grind to get this card. He's only going for 50k right now. That's only 30k away. If I sell my Andre Iguodala, I might be able to snag this card. Hold up. 91 three-point shot, not bad. His driving dunk's a 97, holy crap. Pretty decent passing. 94 perimeter defense. Good rebounding stats for a guard. 95 speed, not too shabby. 45 Hall of Fame badges. Does he have like range extender and stuff? His volume shooter, catch and shoot, that's good. Range extender, yeah, okay. Clamps, intimidator. I didn't see if he had dead iron or not. I don't think he did. Yeah, he has gold dead eye, that kind of sucks. I wonder why he's going for so cheap. Let's see how much he goes for. I think that one was like 50k, so I wonder if it goes under 50. Oh, he does. He goes for like 49. Whoa, guys. I might have to try and snag this card here in the next couple of days. If this card keeps getting low like this. He goes for 48k. Wow, I'm only 20,000 away. I might have to do some grinding tonight, boys. I might have to pick up another Galaxy Opal for the lineups. That's pretty cool, because I can definitely put him at a small 46-7. That's not bad at all. That's dope. Was there another card I wanted to look at? Oh yeah, Siakam. I wanted to show you guys a Siakam card. I already looked up this one because I was super excited about this card, but I wish I could get this card as my small four. I mean, my power forward, he's still going for a bid, which makes sense. This card's going to be really dope. Let's compare it to Brian Scalabrine. Obviously not going to have that good of a three-point shot, but compared to Brian, but watch out for Joel Embiid. God, that's so cheesy. Really good passing skills as well. Only 98 in terms of defense, which isn't that good. I feel like they would have given him a 99 rebound. 92 speed, holy crap. 46 Hall of Fame badges. That is insanity. That is insane. Okay, well, let's check out this Nash. I'm gonna guess he's going for buy now, so I don't think he's gonna be for bids. Yep, he's going for under 70k. That's crazy. Really good 3-point shot, but again, oh wait, this Nash is 6'3. Is Nash 6'3? Am I being stupid? Did I just totally forget that Steve Nash is 6'3? I think just because he hasn't dunked, like, ever in his career, really. I guess I kind of forgot, but he has an 80 driving dunk, which isn't bad. He has almost 99 all for passing. Only a 90 perimeter defense, so 97 steal, which is pretty great. Rebounding is pretty eh, but he has 99 speed, 99 acceleration. That's pretty awesome. And 47 all of his badges. Wow. Yeah, like I said, just defensively, he's probably not going to be that great. He probably doesn't have a lot of strength either. I know this Lonzo guard doesn't have any strength at all. Yeah, Lonzo has less strength than Nash. When I'm trying to back people down in the post with Lonzo, because he's taller than a lot of guards, you just can't back him down, which really sucks, but looks like this guard's going for about 70k. And then we add the A-word guard. I think I spelled it wrong. I think it's W, right? Just his first name. Did I spell it wrong? And was I just stupid? I don't know. Oh, he's going for 100k plus bids. That's crazy. 95-3. That's pretty good. Pretty good. 90 driving dunk. Pretty good passing. 94 perimeter defense. 85 into so it's not that long of a video, but I did lose one, and then I won one. But when I lost, the guy had the out-of-position LeBron, which is probably the craziest card I've ever played on any 2K of all time. The dude had the out-of-position LeBron. I think he had out-of-position Draymond at point guard, and then he had some other big diamond or galaxy. I probably don't remember, but those two cards together are really cheesy because my Lonzo had a guard Draymond. I mean, my Lonzo had a guard. I think he had a guard LeBron or Draymond. I'm not sure. So every time they just went to the post and just locked down Lonzo, and then Clyde had a guard the other guy, which is totally tough. And then my Kristaps was facing some, you know, irrelevant player, so he just didn't really have to help a lot on the interior. So Lonzo and Clyde were just by themselves the whole time, and it just got totally annihilated. This game, we have Shaq here trying to take over by himself, but wow, look at the block right there by Clyde. Beautiful, beautiful block. Alonzo going all the way. This Lonzo card is still my favorite card I have. I don't think it's going to change for a little bit until I get like a better card, but yo, this Lonzo is still my favorite card. I love the Kristaps, he's really good. And due to the fact that he has the Shaq positioned where he is, my Clyde Drexler has to guard Shaq, which, you know, this boy is just going to go in the paint and dominate me the whole game, which is stupid, but it's very tough. But I have a very quick team. His team's all centers and power forwards, so I'm just trying to use my speed against him. See if I can get right there. Good passing, but not a good shot. It was a very early release, so I'm still trying to figure out Kristaps' jump shot. Beautiful defense right there from me, but still couldn't get the rebound. Tries to shoot with Shaq. Misses, thank God. And beautiful passing right there. I'm surprised Shaq didn't actually block that, to be honest. Man, this Shaq card is, it's probably one of the best cards as well. He's up there with LeBron and probably the GOAT Kobe and the GOAT MJ cards. Those are probably the top cards in the game. And this Shaq is definitely one of them as well. I just saw his first possession. He did a step back, you know, snagged that ball right back and just shot a three right in my face. That was a good move right there from Lonzo. I'm trying to abuse the Xiao Qi. I think his name is Xiao Qi. I think it's the name of this card he's using. I'm trying to abuse that card a little bit. Double teaming Shaq, but that was a very poor decision on my end because I forgot the Great Garden Guard is a 3-point shooter as well. Good little baseline cheese right there, trying to get to inside using my speed against them. We're up right now, I think, by 1 point. Again, sorry, I forgot that the yellow is very hard to see with the white scoring, so that's my bad. Just glad getting dunked on. I was getting really upset about that because I don't know why they would have. I wish you could do defensive settings on 3v3 so you can tell which players to guard who, because I would definitely have Kristaps on Shaq because he's obviously going to use that card a lot more. Good passing and a nice green from Clyde right there. Clyde's jump shot's really easy. It's really fast, so it's pretty easy to remember. So I get greens on him pretty evenly, but he just nutmegged me with Shaq. It's pretty crazy. I know he's looking for the three, so I'm trying to stay up on him, give him some space, and then just let him shoot it. So that's a good defensive strategy by me. Just let him keep shooting with the Shaq, give him some space, then close in really fast. Gonna see if he's gonna help, but he's not going to. So I'm gonna go on the bus with Kristaps and cuff out. So it's not too bad. Try to get Lonzo the ball here with the Great Garden, who's not as fast. So I'm just trying to get my guys open. And good passing again. Boom, another good shot. From Clyde, having them chase me around is definitely the way to win this game. Use my speed, we're up by 3 right now, 17-14. And wow, that was a lucky miss. Clyde Drexler right now is on fire, so that's good. And again, just trying to use the speed of Lonzo to get around Greg. Just trying to get Shaq out of the game as much as possible, because I know that's the player he's really trying to use and abuse, so. Again, good strip right there from Lonzo. Amazing right there, and a nice dunk. Oh, actually, wow. Okay, so that was 19. I thought it was 18 points, but we actually had 19. So yeah, I won my first game pretty luckily, because that Shaq, like I said, is an insane card. If that player was a little bit better, no offense if that player's watching, but if you'd used that player a little bit smarter, you probably would have beat me 100%, because all you needed was that one card, and I definitely would have lost. There's no doubt about it, but that was drop next, which I don't play online, as you guys know, so it's not like I have a very insane little was just like some MD, but I guess I could show you guys that. But yeah, again, I'm super sorry that that happened with the original gameplay, but I did lose one of the games, so maybe I'll have some luck on my next game as well. Maybe we'll get two wins instead of a win and a loss, but I definitely don't win all of my games, I'll tell you that much. Here we have, you know, just a random ball drop. But I also need to know if, for some reason, sometimes my for the ball drop will pop up sometimes. Let me know if that happens for you guys. I don't know if it's because I don't play this that often. It makes me do the ball drop tutorial for this sometimes. Let me know if that's like a glitch I have or something like that, but sometimes the ball drop tutorial will pop up randomly, which is kind of funny. But as you can see here, I just got 200 MT, nothing too crazy. Say, you know. I only play offline. Well, there's a reason why I only play offline is because people